Hello.
Everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we're talking about things I feel like need to be talked about more. These are my top underrated products that personally I love but feel like they don't get the attention that they deserve. Make sure you are subscribed if you aren't already. The button is in this corner, this one. Will I ever remember that? Who knows? But subscribe if you haven't and give this video a thumbs up if you do enjoy at any point. Before we get into the makeup, I have a very exciting announcement. I'm officially a partner with Ana Luisa. Now, I have partnered with them several times before. I absolutely love their sustainability mission and they make absolutely beautifully made jewelry. So over the next year, I will be sharing with you some new jewelry pieces from them along with some of their best sales. I'm super excited about this. I love jewelry. I feel like it's kind of underrated in terms of how it affects your overall look. Over the past couple years, I've just been really in love with jewelry and how it changes your whole look. So I do have three new pieces from them I want to share with you. You may have seen me wear a lot of their jewelry before. Actually, in I would say the majority of my videos, I'm wearing at least one Ana Luisa piece, but I do have three new ones to share with you. The first one is the necklace that I'm wearing right here. I will go ahead and insert a close-up, but this is just a super dainty, pretty layering piece. I wanted a shorter necklace that I could wear with my longer necklaces or just on its own like this. That's a little more subtle. This one is adjustable, so you can make it a little bit longer, but I just love how it sits almost like a choker on the shortest length. Absolutely beautiful. A little bit of a sparkle, but not too much. The next piece I picked out are these earrings. Now, I have nothing like this in my collection, so I really wanted something pretty dainty, and they have these cute little pearls on the end of them. And also, the sort of top part here where it sits on your ear has this hammered, like organic metal look to it, which I feel like adds a little bit more edge to the pearls. So again, another dainty piece that I feel like is just super wearable, or if you want to dress any sort of look up. And last but not least are the earrings I have in now. These are really gorgeous little mini hoops with a just like crystal on the end of them, and they're sort of like a pave style, so they are crystalled all around the hoop and then they have a big dangly one on the bottom of it. If you're interested in checking out any of their jewelry, they really have a broad range of prices and styles depending on what you like. I feel like they will have something for you. I have a personalized discount code from them. I will pop it on the screen. It will also be in the description for the rest of the year. If you ever want to check their site out, just check in my description below. These rings are also from Ana Luisa, but that was it for the little sponsored portion of today's video. Let's go ahead and get into my top underrated products. So starting with a primer I really enjoy, but don't feel like people talk enough about it. I feel like this brand in general actually kind of fits into that category. This is from Vesca Beauty. It's the Soft Sun Radiant Skin Primer and Luminizer. This comes in several different shades. I have the shade Sunrise, which is a really pretty soft gold. It comes in a really convenient little squirt bottle, squeezy bottle, squirt bottle, you know. So the shimmer in this is very, very subtle. As you can see, it just gives this super flattering glow to the skin. It just has a nice mix between like a moisturizing primer and a smoothing primer. Like, it kind of just gives you a really pretty glowy base to work off of, but it doesn't disrupt sunscreen or makeup. And it goes well with my skincare, which is really important. I don't typically use a ton of primers, but this is one I find myself gravitating towards because it just adds that really pretty glow under makeup. Next, for foundation, I kind of didn't know what to mention, but I thought that the NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Full Coverage Foundation isn't widely talked about. At least I haven't really heard anyone talk about this foundation. I absolutely love this. It's full coverage, it's matte, so it's not gonna be for everybody, but like, it is the most long-wearing foundation I have, and it looks flawless over texture, which is pretty rare for such a matte foundation. And I really love the shades that they offer as well, and the price point. You can't really beat it. I think this is an underrated formula for sure from the drugstore. I have two concealers that I think are underrated. The first one is from Dermablend. This is the CoverCare Full Coverage Concealer. This is not my favorite for under the eyes, although I do feel like it looks pretty good. This is just so amazing for covering blemishes because it's such a full coverage concealer. It comes in a really wide tube, so the doe foot picks up a lot of product. This is the shade N6, by the way. So it's definitely a thicker consistency, kind of similar to Tarte Shape Tape, but a little bit more moisturizing. It just looks really beautiful and ends up looking so seamless on the skin. Also, I think I picked just such a good shade. It really blends in immediately. This I've been using constantly to cover blemishes because it gets the job done with less product, so it makes everything look less cakey if I just go in with like one really good full coverage concealer. So I absolutely love this for blemishes or any other areas that I feel like need some more intense coverage. Next, my favorite under eye concealer. This is so good. I know this is a newer launch, but I still feel like it needs more hype to it. It's the Thrive Cosmetics Buildable Blur HD Creaseless Concealer. This is a very thin formula. So this concealer is a thinner formula, but it just looks so beautiful under the eyes. I do have a lot of problems with creasing, just sort of because of my eye shape. I have more round eyes and I just get natural lines and creases under my eyes. But this has the perfect amount of coverage. It's more of like a light medium. It's not light coverage, I would say it's like a medium, but on the lighter side of medium type of coverage. But you can sort of build it up however you want it. It stays super thin. It's very cakeless and creaseless. It literally just looks like skin, which I think is very rare for an under eye concealer. It's just one of those products I can't stop using. Every time I try to use a different under eye concealer, I just regret not using this. That's how good it is. So yeah, this is an amazing concealer and it deserves more hype. It really does. Moving on to bronzers, I feel like this category specifically is always about onto the next new best formula, but there's already a lot of really beautiful formulas that already exist, or maybe you have some in your collection that you love and just haven't used in a while. Before we move on, if you have a product in your collection you feel like is underrated, definitely let me know below because I'd love to try your underrated product. Leave me a comment, I'd love to hear from you. But my first pick is from Cover FX. This is the Bronzer Drop product. This is the shade Sunkissed. I believe this came out last summer. So basically, this is a liquid, like very pigmented cream bronzer product, liquid bronzer actually. I love this shade. A little bit goes such a long way. If you have a skin tone similar to mine, this just offers the prettiest, like more neutral bronze. It has this glow to it, but it's very subtle and the tone of it, I just find extremely flattering. And like I mentioned, a little bit just goes such a long way. I do this a lot actually under foundation, just as like some underpainting before I do foundation. That's actually what I did today. And you can see it sort of shining through. It's just a beautiful product with a ton of coverage and pigment to it. And you can mix this in with foundations, mix it in with a moisturizer. I just love a multi-purpose, just really effective formula. This is definitely it. A more sheer bronzer formula that I really love is from OG. This is the Hydroganic Sculpted Face Stick. I believe I actually used this in my previous makeup tutorial. That's the shade Sunkissed. Again, very neutral, very wearable, doesn't look orange. This one has a little bit more of a glow to it, but this just reminds me of like Westman Atelier, but better. I just feel like they're so pretty and glowy and easy to use. If you like more of that like no makeup makeup look, you like something more glowy, more dewy, just more of that like dewy, dewy face, then I think you would really love this from OG. It also feels extremely luxurious, nice and heavy. They have a couple different shades of these and it's just a superb formula. One powder bronzer formula I love is from Flower Beauty. This is the Heatwave Luminous Bronzer. This is the shade Sunrise. I picked this up sort of on a whim quite a while ago, and it kind of looks different on the skin than it looks in the pan, but this is just such a pretty baked bronzer. Even on my finger, it looks a little bit gray, but it almost transforms into like just this gorgeous warmth. So stunning. If you have a skin tone similar to mine, you feel like a lot of bronzers pull weird tones on you, give this one a shot because it's just gorgeous. When I have no tan on or when I am tan, I feel like it works beautifully either way. It's really buildable and soft, and I just love the baked luminous formula. It really just adds a lot of life to your face. Next, I have two cream blush formulas that I absolutely love. We'll start with the one which is probably the first cream blush I ever got into. These are the Juice Beauty Last Looks cream blush. So I have two shades here. My favorite, ooh, am I hitting pan? That's exciting. I don't think I've ever hit pan on a cream product. Hopefully that says something. This is the shade Flush, which is just the prettiest neutral nude pink. So these aren't super pigmented right off the bat. They have more of this like buildable juiciness to it. Now, the reason I love these over a lot of other cream blushes is because they give your cheeks like this glow to it. Like it really makes them look plump and dewy, but it's not too oily and also doesn't disrupt my makeup, and it has a really good wear time. So this is just stunning. The other shade I have is called Orange Blossom. I believe I first discovered this in a Patti Vore box. There's the other shade. It's kind of on top of my bronzer hand. Let me wash that off. But anyway, really pretty, really juicy, beautiful cream blushes. I believe you can pick these up on Ulta. Credo Beauty probably has them. They're just stunning and, you know, they've really gotten their use. They really have. Next is another little cutie from Rituelle des Filles. This is the Color Nectar Pigment Balm. This one specifically is Bee Sting. I think this brand in general is sort of more an indie brand. It's underrated. So this is more like a balmy, just super, look at that pigment. That is so pretty. I actually have this one on today. More of this balmy, richly pigmented, just beautiful blush, and it just makes it look like it's your own cheek color. It's really indescribable what it does, but it's just such a stunning formula. The way that I applied it today is I put some on the back of my hand and then I use a dense sort of blending brush and tap it on. You could also use a sponge or your fingers would work really well, but it just lays really evenly, gives you a little bit of glow to your cheeks, but it's just so pretty. I don't know how to describe it. They also have a lot of fun, unique shades, which I definitely appreciate in a cream blush. So this is just, also smells really good. Such a beautiful product. And one powder blush I wanted to mention is from Found Beauty. This is a brand you can find at Walmart. It's the Peach Glow Just Baked Blush. This is a really good dupe for the Antonym Baked Blushes. I actually like this one a little bit more. Pretty light, as you can see on my hand, but they do have a couple different shades. This one's just a really gorgeous peach glow. Really soft, beautiful formula that just gives your cheek a little bit of glow. Should we put some on? I'm just gonna put a little bit on. Like, it just looks so pretty and it doesn't emphasize texture. It's a gorgeous formula that doesn't emphasize texture. It's also very affordable, which is awesome, and just a really underrated brand. I feel like if you went to Walmart and saw this brand, you'd probably be kind of confused on what to get because not a lot of reviews out there. I did actually do a review of the brand, I believe last year. I will link it if you're interested in what else is good from the brand, but that's one of my favorites. The next product you would not know by looking at it, but this is such a gorgeous highlight. So this is from Pixi. It's the Glowy Gossamer Duo in Delicate Dew. I believe this is one of like their permanent line items. If not, they always have collabs going on with different highlighter palettes, but this is a duo from them. Now these look like very weird formulas in the pan, but let me tell you, just look at the glow. These are so interesting. I mainly use this light pink one over here, but you also get a bronze one. You can mix these depending on your skin tone. They look like they would almost be too metallic, but on the skin, they meld with your skin so unbelievably well. Like, you wouldn't think such a metallic looking highlighter would do that, but if you like that wet looking skin, this is the product for you if you want a powder and don't want to have to use a cream. I have this one on today. Like, it really doesn't look like highlight. It just gives you that glow while being undetectable, and it's just a smooth, really workable formula, which I love. So this is a total hit from Pixi. Moving on to shadows, the cream eyeshadow I picked, which is also from the brand Vesca. It's called the Moonlight Dream Cream Shadow. They don't have a ton of shades of these, but it's just my favorite cream shadow formula. This one I have is the shade Lyra, which I have on my lids today, but here's a bigger swatch. So this is just, you know when you have a cream or liquid eyeshadow and maybe it's a little bit too glittery or it has fallout or it makes your eyelids look wrinkly and weird? This one does not do that at all. It's the perfect wearable cream shadow. I feel like a lot of the metallic shadows I have that are liquid sometimes just aren't the most daytime friendly product, but this I could totally wear in the daytime. Like, it just looks so pretty and has the most finely milled like shimmers in it. I wouldn't even call it glitter. It has some gold. It looks like it has some different shades of pink. It's just so stunning, and it dries down and really does not budge. It doesn't flake. It's just such a stunning formula. I would love to see more shades from them, but so pretty. Another cream shadow eyeshadow product I really enjoy is from Thrive Cosmetics. So these are the Brilliant Eye Brighteners. I have two shades, two of my favorites here. First is a new shade to the line, which is called Betty, which is this gorgeous baby blue. Then the other shade I have is called Terra, which is a pretty, one of like a muted rose gold. These just stay impeccably well and they're so smooth and easy to use. I actually used this one as an eyeliner before. I have this one on currently right under my lash line. Perfect for like the inner corner, your lash line, as a liner, really however you want to use it. These sort of adapt to however you're using them. It's a beautiful multi-use product that I'm always reaching for, and yeah, pretty simple but very good. Next, the NYX Epic Wear eyeliners. I think these are so underrated and they're my favorite stick liner formula I've tried so far, and they're from the drugstore. I have the metallics and the matte shades. They have so many different fun shades, which is so cool. They have mattes, they have metallics, they have any color you could sort of envision, they have it. So let me swatch all three of these for you. So this formula is really budge proof. It's one of the only liners I feel like stays on my waterline. I have a yellow here. Let me find the shades. Cosmic Yellow. The one in the middle is Gilded Taupe, which is that bronze. And then the one on the end is called Orange Zest. So these two are metallic and then the yellow one is a matte. But these have amazing staying power and you don't need to be shelling out a bunch of money for a high-end liner when these exist because they're so good. I have so many other colors, but these were just three that I wanted to mention. Such a home run. If you see these at the drugstore, at Target, definitely pick one up. I think you'd love it. Onto lipsticks, you've probably all heard of the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk lipstick, but I have two other shades from Charlotte that I feel like are a little bit underrated. One is very similar to Pillow Talk, but I think I actually might prefer this one a little bit more just with my skin tone. So this is the same Matte Revolution formula, but this is the shade Very Victoria. So these look pretty similar, but they do have different undertones. So this is Pillow Talk here, the cult classic. And then this is Very Victoria, which is my personal favorite. It has a little bit more of a cooler tone. It leans a bit more mauve. It's just so pretty and flattering. Sometimes Pillow Talk, I think, pulls a little bit too pink on me, depending if I'm self-tanned or not. But I love Very Victoria. It's the same great Matte Revolution formula. And I actually find myself using that one more than Pillow Talk. Even though I love both, I think Very Victoria should be hyped up more. And then another shade from their lipstick collection, but this is a kissing lipstick formula, which is the more satin moisturizing formula. I actually didn't like this color at first, but it's grown on me. This is Penelope Pink. So it's a much more peachy nude. It's actually described as neutral online, but I feel like it's pretty peachy. Now this on its own, when I'm fair, I don't think looks good, but when I have a tan on and I do like a deeper lip liner, maybe like a NYX nude beige or nude truffle lip liner, and then do this, it just is really pretty and gives you that very nude lip without being too washed out. Again, not something I think would work on me, but it surprisingly did. So I just really like how flattering it is, even though I didn't expect it to be, and I thought I should mention it as an underrated product. A lipstick formula I think is underrated, but is one of my favorites, is from Victoria Beckham, the Posh lipstick. If you like a moisturizing, more like sheer buildable type of lipstick, these are the product for you. They are so pretty. Wow, that actually kind of looks like the Charlotte one. A bit deeper though, this is the shade Spice. So perfect to throw in your bag. I really like the tube and packaging. It's nice and slim. You can get a nice line going with it. Not a line, but you know, it applies your lipstick pretty evenly. They also come in a bunch of beautiful nudes and more fun shades. I think they actually just recently expanded the shades for these, which is so exciting. I have a bunch of other shades, but so good. I love these. I don't know why I keep breaking out in song, bad song, for no reason. It's one of those days. To finish everything off, two liquid lipstick formulas I think should be talked about more are the Patrick Ta Silky Lip Cream. I use this so much. If you watch any of my makeup tutorials, chances are you've seen me use this before. This is the shade She's Independent. Now this is the perfect like nude beige. There it is in my thumb crease there. Just so pretty and flattering, and I love the formula because it is a full coverage liquid lipstick, but it doesn't completely dry down, so it leaves sort of just like a moistness on your lips so they don't look dry and crusty. They look nice and healthy, but it does give you a good amount of wear time. Sometimes I'll just apply this with my fingers for like a lighter wash, and it works really well that way too. And then I think the Honest Beauty liquid lipstick is a similar formula as to where it doesn't dry down, leaves your lips looking still alive and healthy, but gives you good color payoff and longevity. This is the shade Love. I don't know if this was limited edition, but you can find these on Amazon. I will link them below. I also really love the shade BFF. This red I love. I feel like it's the perfect toned red. It has some more blue undertone, so it's very teeth flattering. Really beautiful formula. I feel like it's a little bit glossier looking maybe than the Patrick Ta one. I don't know. They're very similar. I love them both. But those were all of the underrated products I wanted to talk about. Again, let me know in the comments below what is an underrated product that you have that you wish more people talked about or knew about. Comment below. I'd love to hear what your favorites are. And thank you again to Ana Luisa for partnering with me. And I will have the discount code for you to shop their site on the screen here and check description for more information. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you found it enjoyable at any point. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.